baby.
What's good, everybody? My name is Ryan Hampton, and I am going to play Truth or Drink. So check this. I mean, not to toot my own horn. Have I ever been on a bad date? Absolutely not. Not that I claim, for real. But, I mean, there was this one day I went with somebody where I just felt like she was just, like, way more advanced. As we went out, you know, and we had a lot in common. We were talking some good shit, and then just as we unfolded, she was, like, delving into, like, her African spirituality, like, actually, like, religious practices, like, Ifa and stuff like that, like, Nigerian-based Africans. I'm just like, oh, wow, I don't know nothing about that. And then, so that's one. And then at the same time, she was like queer identifying, which I don't have a problem with, but it's just like, on top of that, she's polyamorous and everything. So it's just like a lot of like, nothing bad at all. I'm having a good time, but it's just like over time, like, yeah, that beat, I cannot keep up with. I cannot lie to you. I mean, she still look good though. I'll be in DM. I might try to hang out with her again sometime. She's cool people, but yeah. Me. Who's an annoying person? Shout out to my friend Destiny. Destiny's my, you know, that's the good homie for real. You know, she's good people, but yeah, she's a little unhinged. But she'll probably say the same about me. So, what's the last lie I told? Nah, don't worry, I paid for that speeding ticket. Just playing. Oh yeah, I pay your tickets. I pay. No. But I've thought about it. I always kind of thought, like, how would I really, like, handle that if, like, presented the opportunity? Like, I feel like I'm not too shrewd enough to say no at this point, but I don't know. Shout out to that, though. 29, but I mean, so, but sometimes it's actually ironic, because the older I get as an adult, in my adulthood, I'm realizing that a lot of older women, if you're just having, like, a reasonable conversation, they do not care about age. I'm just like, wow. So I'll get back to you if I ever get up there to, like, 35. It's a fun time. It's a fun space to like, navigate through sometimes. I'm not gonna lie. No, and I'll be honest, I mean, look, I don't know if this isn't like necessarily like a bad thing. Just my parents growing up, they never been the most romantically showing parents. You know, they very much probably loved each other in their own way. But if you ask me, you just look like a really solid, good, like co-living, like codependency kind of relationship. But sometimes I'd be wondering, like, damn, are y'all still like having a sexual connection? What's the worst thing I've done while I was young? Next question. Can't answer that one. Maybe my biggest regret was in my previous relationship. I guess this is real deep on these type of questions. My previous relationship, which we're really cool peoples now all together, like just good friends. But like at the time, I might have not been the most financially secure young man at the time. So I might have like have not been the most supportive of my like person and like supporting like my ex-girlfriend at the time, because she was like getting like the jobs and like the consistency of like work on her end and stuff like that. So maybe at the time, that was a couple years ago, I've been through some growth now and stuff like that, but at the time, it's like that one Martin episode where Gina's making more money than him and he couldn't handle it. Like a little bit. The last time I cried. I might have shed like a little tear when I thought like, oh, my grandmother was gonna pass on something, but like, you know, that was just a medical misunderstanding at the time, so it's fine. But last time I cried, I don't cry too often. Maybe we should cry. Should black men cry more? Yeah, should. Biggest pet peeve. I know I have pet peeves. That's the thing. I just can't think of any. Why are you a black woman and you don't like Beyonce? That's my pet peeve. You know what it is? I think that's like, if we're gonna be like for real in the realm. So like, there's been times like you don't even have to be a Beyonce fan for real. But why are you, black woman, melanated, shaded woman, just go out your way to talk shit about? That's just crazy. Can't you get tied up a little bit? Rank them. You know what? Yeah. Shout out to Randy, Rodney, and Tanisha. I promise you it's me. I'm the Trojan horse of the house. I'm gonna let you know that I'm the one that's asking questions. I'm the one that's like out here playing comedic relief and shit, like just for the sake of it. So I was the youngest low-key of like growing up like in my family. So like I would most likely be the most annoying one to everybody else. No, but that's also coming from the fact that at one point in time I tried, but also in growth now, she's like, what do I gain from that? Why are we holding on to the previous things in that way? There's so much more out there to offer. Okay, I'm gonna drink, but I'm gonna just answer anyway. Because, I mean, it's okay, a couple embarrassing things, I guess. I mean, actually, it wasn't embarrassing. It wasn't embarrassing. My teacher was just being a dickhead at the time, I'm gonna be honest. Like, she just like, I need to go. I was like in fifth grade. I need to use the bathroom. This white lady was just not letting me go. Only so much you can do. Had to. You had to. If I had to, nigga, like, it was like, figure. I'm like, bro, like, what you mean, bro? Like, what you mean? I gotta sign a hall pass, bro. Like, what do you mean, bro? And then I had to call my mama and everything. That's crazy. No. I do follow this one black-owned magazine, and she's, like, very, like, sex-positive type thing. Like, or they have, like, a social media presence online. I think things like that where they, like, promote, like, pro-black sex tips or just, like, energy and stuff like that. I like that. I like real-life interaction. I don't like fictional books, like, that you see in Walmart. That's a wild question. I'm gonna sit here and say I did not personally agree with any of his rhetoric at the time. When it's like stuff like that, I don't pay attention to that a lot. Like I don't know nothing about Andrew Tate. Just look at Twitter. Apparently he's going down for something crazy. Kevin Samuels. The craziest thing I saw about Kevin Samuels was when he died and we was at a bar on E Street and they said they had RIP Kevin Samuels on like with the bottle girls with sparklers and everything in the club. And I was like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this information. The last illegal thing I did, I'm boring as fuck. I'm a very law-abiding citizen. Shout out to Art, Music, and Clothes for having me out here today. This has been a very fun time. Follow me on Instagram, @thatcanongoboom. And just watch out for more future projects, more short film content, more content creation to come in 2023. Thank you. Bye. Take a break and roll a sticky, let it high.